Hey everybody, welcome to Design Make Teach, a channel for makers and maker educators. I'm Josh Ajima, and today we're talking Flexy Tree Ornaments. Flex, 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 flex. So this is an original design. It's not a remix, but it is based on some really cool designs. The original Snake by Zomboe on Thingiverse was a classic of this kind of flexible design. Design work, and then also Flexy Rex by my friend Jim. Jim wrote a Zang 3. Same thing, has this flexible design. So how does this work, right? So there's a thin spine in the center, and then there's these struts that kind of come off of it. And what happens is PLA and 3D printed stuff can bend a little bit, and these struts keep that bend angle for any individual bend really small, right? There's little cutouts here, and it can only go so far in each spot. But if you add up a little bit of bend for each one of these, it lets you have this really great, awesome, flexible shape. So in the examples that I showed, Snake by Zomboe, this is out of Ninja Flex here, but it doesn't have to be, because the Flexy Rex, this is out of regular PLA, hard stuff, but it still gives you that really great flexible flexible look to it. So this is a design I'm sharing with you on my blog, and you know, this wasn't crazy. It wasn't really hard to do. All of this is a triangle, and then a little rectangle here at the bottom, and then I'm cut out in Illustrator. I did all this one, this design I did in Illustrator, cut out little holes, or rectangles on the side here, out of that shape, and so that gives you kind of a basic holiday pine tree sort of thing for the winter, and then if you put a star on the top, and boom, it's a Christmas tree. So that's pretty a pretty cool design, and it's a way of taking somebody else's idea, in this case the idea of these flexible sorts of designs here, which is a practical application. And I'm sure those are based on like wooden toys earlier, where you'd like cut out slots or put a piece of cloth in the center. So you know, even though I'm crediting Zomboe and Zang for their designs, they probably base the idea or concept on something that they've seen in the past. So super cool sharing with you and a look at the Illustrator file. One thing that's really important for you to do to look at when you're printing this is look at the slicer preview. And when you look at that central spine, for this one, I have it at 0.6 millimeters, but you might have to adjust to 0.8 or 1.2. You want it to be a multiple of your extrusion width. So if your extrusion width is 0.4, you're gonna want it to be a multiplier of that. Now, when you look in your slicer, you want those lines on the spine to be parallel to each other. So that's gonna give you strength. If those lines actually come like this, some of the slicers will do angles, and they'll butt up against each other, and that's where the design will break when it starts to flex. So you do want to take a look at your preview and make sure the spine and all the outline all the way around is continuous. And so let's throw up an example of that from Simplify 3D. All right, so just wanted to share that quick design with you. I've used that for some other things. Here's the Flexy Washington Monument, and I have a Flexy Empire State Building. And so just a super simple concept that you can take and adapt and make your own flexy thing. So thanks for watching, and have the best day ever.